seeing, it is a carbon fiber cello. Carbon fiber means it is just like fiberglass, except the matting of the fiberglass was replaced by carbon matting. So this is the same material that the latest airplanes are made of. It's very light, stronger than steel, supposedly the carbon, and it's a real instrument. It's a cellist of the Boston Symphony who invented the instrument. I talked to him at length about it, and he said he was a passionate sailor, and he would go out sailing, and he heard the water splashing against his hull, the hull of his boat, and he was wondering if it was possible to make a cello out of that kind of material and give it a decent sound. And it took him 15 years of research to come up with all the different components, the epoxy, the carbon, the molds, and so on. And then he found a boat builder who partnered up with him, and they started this company. It's a wonderful instrument to travel with. And it's my turn for a little solo piece, so I like, before I get into the playing, as you may know, I have a recording studio, so I often combine technology with acoustic instruments. And I think it's a very exciting time to do music. It's an amazing opportunity to record and to distribute it over the internet and so on. And one of the things that I am always surrounded with every time I go into my studio is digital technology. When we really think about it, what is digital technology? It is a sampling. It is a taking snapshots in time very rapidly and capturing what we call the analog world and translating into little packets of information at a certain resolution, right? And it's a binary code system. Digital is essentially zeros and ones. It basically looks at 0101, 0101, 0101 very rapidly. And it comes up with a code that then we can burn onto a CD, and then it can get decoded, and we listen to beautiful music. Or in my case, what I'm going to demonstrate now, I have a device called a digital looper, which is a box where you can record yourself in real time and then play to it. So I'm gonna put that to work now, and then hopefully come up with something beautiful for you. When you use digital equipment, you have to take your shoes off. It's required. So I have to do that. Stick it on with tape or with adhesive, and my cello teacher would just let me have it. Say, how can you do that? But it led to many good things in my life. So I also had the pickup mounted on this cello. All right, let's see.
Thank you.
Lynn Gudmundsen, she knows how to rip it up like I feel.
Well, please feel free to sing with this one. I think you probably know the words. If not, you can sing La La La. pop music and rock and roll, if you make a mistake, they say just make the same mistake again, everybody will think it's right. But in this kind of music, you make a mistake, you can't hide it.
Oh, did you make a mistake?
I did.
I already made about 10 mistakes tonight, to be honest. It's all the art of covering it up. That's what it's all about.
Thank you.
might be a good moment to actually thank also Third Avenue Playhouse for inviting us to play here. And I'm standing here not just as a musician, but I recently joined the board of directors for Third Avenue Playhouse because this place is really very dear to my heart. And I've lived in California for 20 years before I moved to Sturgeon Bay in Door County. So I've been in the midst of the cutting edge communities of the United States, and to have a theater like this is priceless. But it costs something to have it, actually. So what I'm learning as I as a new board member is the importance of the support of the community, because it is truly a community theater, especially TAP. We have children's programming here. You saw the kids earlier today. There's some children's theater, which seems to be really popular. This gives a great opportunity to get in touch with their creative side. You know, they're not getting graded. You know, they're not getting judged. They can be truly creative, and there's some great stories emerging from that. Furthermore, of course, we have other theater productions. We have music here, and we have dreams of things yet to come to Third Avenue Playhouse. So in that spirit, I'd like to ask you to consider making a donation to TAP, whether it is today, or maybe as a Christmas gift, or for next year, or if you have a business, you can advertise. It really is worth doing that. I'm going to make a nice donation as a business entity in Sturgeon Bay. We have set ourselves a goal of opening up the back room as a second theater for next year at some point to increase creativity, opportunities for the community, you know, to have a venue where they can try things out. For example, more adventurous theater productions, reading scripts for people that have always wanted to try it, for maybe some musical programming that's a little bit off the beaten track. So for all those reasons, we're going to try to open that second room. And for all those reasons, every dollar that you give to this theater will go directly towards making that possible. So I hope you consider that. Thank you.
Bravo.
Along with. We have a little of a ball.
myself know that I have to count, and it's very easy. One little slip off the track and train wreck, so it's easy.
But I'm glad you kept going, because it's not a gift.
It's a gift.
Yes.
So, sing along with us.